Hello students, from this video we will be discussing about Kingdom Animalia and its different phyla. To begin with, let's see the characteristic features of Kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia includes organisms also known as metazoa. Metazoans are the organisms having many cells, with cells differentiating into tissues and organs. They are heterotrophic except poriferans. There are approximately 9 to 10 million species on Earth, but only a small fraction of these species have been identified. So when we think about Animalia, the first thought is about the word animal. Word animal arises from a Latin word animalis. Animalis means having breath or having soul, that is living. All the organisms belonging to Kingdom Animalia are multicellular, eukaryotic and heterotrophic. When we look around us, there are diverse life forms, and these diverse life forms live in different habitats. These habitats include mostly marine water, that is sea, fresh water, and few of these species also live on land. When we say diverse, it is not only with respect to appearance but also with respect to size. So they vary from few millimeters like rotifers to large size like blue whales. Most of the animals are bilaterally symmetrical, while others like sponges are asymmetrical. Coelenterates and echinoderms are radially symmetrical. We would be discussing about symmetry in our next video. Organisms in this kingdom are motile. Motility in these organisms are brought about by a set of muscles. Cells of these multicellular organisms possess elasticity and are without cell wall. They do have membrane-bound cell organelles like nucleus and mitochondria, etc. Organisms belonging to Kingdom Animalia show different levels of body organization as we move from lower to higher organisms. Some show cellular level, tissue level of organization, while others also show organ and organ system level of organization. Different types of organ system like respiratory, circulatory, excretory, digestive are present in these animals. When we say diversity, it's not only restricted to appearance but also evolution of organ systems in Animalia. Like respiration in animal happens through lungs, skin, gills, etc. Digestion process starts after the ingestion of food through mouth. Digestion can be intracellular in some organisms, and it also takes place in tubular cavities. Nervous system also has evolved from nerves to ganglia, to spinal cord and to brain. Circulatory system in them includes heart, aorta, blood and associated vessels. Excretion has evolved from mere diffusion to nephridia and from nephridia to kidneys. Reproduction is another phenomena where they differ. Some reproduce sexually, that is by the fusion of sperms and ova, while some asexually, like budding in Hydra. Regeneration may also be considered as a type of asexual reproduction, as in case of Planaria. In sexually reproducing organisms, embryonic development takes place, where sperm and ova fuse to form a diploid zygote. Most of the animals are diploid, except few which are haploid, like bee, ant, wasp, etc. The kingdom Animalia, being the largest, is divided into two main groups or subkingdoms. However, there is a disagreement among scientists regarding these subkingdoms. So the subkingdoms are Parazoa and Eumetazoa. Parazoa are those where the organisms do not show any symmetry and have cellular level of body organizations. Example, poriferans like sponges belong to this category. Eumetazoa, they have organisms which show symmetry and have tissue, organ or organ system level of organization. Example, mammals, birds, etc. The number of phyla in the kingdom Animalia ranges from 35 to 40. In the next video, we will be discussing about basis of classification of Kingdom Animalia into different phyla. Thank you.